snake anti-venom is made. I will take you through a 6-step process of how exactly this production is done. Stick around and enjoy. Creating anti-venom is a very complex and tedious process that begins with milking a live venomous snake. Step 1. Milking the venomous snake. This part is indeed the most dangerous, but it needs to be done because without venom from the snake, we can't make snake anti-venom. Once the snake venom is collected from hundreds of venomous snakes and reaches the desired amount for one vial of anti-venom, the venom is then frozen for transport. Step 2. Freezing the venom. This part of the process is crucial because without the venom being frozen, room temperatures can kill certain proteins in the venom, rendering the venom useless. After a couple of months of milking venomous snakes, there is now enough to freeze dry and store until it is ready to be shipped to a farm. Step 3. Deliver to farm with horses. This part of the process is also very important and is where horses are injected with small amounts of venom for 6 months, each dose getting larger and larger. Step 4. Blood is drawn from the horse. Blood is taken from the horse about every 2 weeks. They shave the horse's neck to prevent any infections, and after about half an hour, all the blood needed is harvested, which is about 6 liters. Step 5. The blood is separated from the plasma. This is the part where the blood that was harvested is separated into plasma, and the rest of the blood is given back to the horse. This plasma is the stuff you are injected with when you are bitten by a venomous snake. And that is how anti-venom is made. Step 6. Save lives. This part is easy and is done by people who are bitten by venomous snakes to get anti-venom and survive. Thanks for watching. If you want to watch my other video about anti-venom, click on the left. And if you want to watch about snake evolution, click on the right. Goodbye, subscribe, and have a splendid day. All I will begin to